Since 1885, the Sisters of St. Mary of Namur have guided the young people of Fort Worth in their faith, education, and citizenship. Their arrival in Fort Worth was at the request of Father Guyot, the pastor of St. Stanislaus Catholic Church in downtown Fort Worth. Father Guyot asked the Sisters of St. Mary of Namur, a Belgian order, to come to teach the children of Fort Worth in scholarship, artistic, cultural, and religious training. On September 14, 1885, the Sisters of St. Mary of Namur opened St. Ignatius Academy, a boarding school for girls at 1222 Throckmorton Street, adjacent to St. Stanislaus Catholic Church.
From the very beginning, when our sisters came to Waco in 1873 and started a little educational venture, being asked because there were so few schools, very quickly we started hearing from people out in rural areas who did not live in the towns where we had our schools, that they wanted their children, and in the beginning their girl children, to have more of an education. So the whole concept of boarders, of a school that would have what would they called day students, as well as a capacity to let children, the girls eventually, stay there during the week and usually then go home on the weekend, that came as a response to the need of a largely rural Texas. So it carried on by the time we came to Fort Worth and began St. Ignatius. That carried on that same tradition.
Many families from the surrounding area of Fort Worth enrolled their daughters in the boarding school, and so the sisters decided to expand again. Ground was broken for the new Our Lady of Victory Academy and Convent on March 25, 1909, with land purchased from the Shaw Brothers Dairy and found at the end of the Hemphill Street streetcar line. At the time, this area was just inside Fort Worth city limits. The surrounding neighborhood was also under development by the George C. Clark Company. The cornerstone was laid August 5, 1909, and the school for girls opened September 12, 1910. On June 9, 1911, OLV held its first graduation ceremony.
At this time, evidently, this property was pasture land, and the Shaw Dairy was, now this was before 1911, before this OLV was ever there. And there was the presence of the KKK in this area. So according to this story, which I don't know whether you want to record, someone said that the cows were in the pasture, but there was one bull, and when the KKK arrived, that bull ran them out.
When the new school was built, it was said, it will be integrated. The sisters all agreed and were happy about it. And that's the way it was. Anybody who did not wish to have a child in the school that was integrated, they were free to leave. And others who wanted to find an integrated school were welcome.
I was a student there from the first through sixth grade, and that's how I got to know the Sisters of St. Mary. And then when I was going into seventh grade, they closed St. Ignatius, and I came out to OLV Elementary for 2 years. So St. Ignatius, it's where I kind of started growing up with the sisters. That's where I got to know them. And that's where I made my first communion, my first confession, and loved the sisters and just loved school.
They formed young women with a superb education, with a great deal of self-confidence, articulate, well-grounded in their faith and morals and ethics, to go out and do their bit for making the world a better place to be.
Always resourceful, the sisters helped make OLV nearly self-sustaining, with a well, water tank, orchard, and garden. The sisters also depended on the power of prayer to help with their everyday needs.
But I remember a sister, Sister Teresa Weber, and I remember her saying one time, I met her in the corridor. I was a senior, I think. and she was frustrated, upset. She said, we have a bill to pay, and I don't have the money. And she said, and I've been praying to St. Joseph. And she had a statue about this tall of St. Joseph on the wall. And she said, you know, I'm just going to turn his statue to face the wall because he hasn't answered my prayer. You know, and she was teasing, but she was sort of serious. Well, then lo and behold, the next morning she told me, you know what? I had to apologize to St. Joseph and turn his statue back around because a check came in the mail that afternoon that paid the bill.
In 1956, a new elementary school was built on the OLV grounds to accommodate young students from the growing Fort Worth Catholic population. Also in 1956, Our Lady of Victory College was moved to a Dallas location, the University of Dallas in Irving, where the Cistercian Fathers and Sisters of St. Mary still teach at the college to this day. Generations of Catholic families sent their sons and daughters to Our Lady of Victory Catholic School. Some continued their Catholic education at Nolan Catholic High School. While the OLV Elementary School will be closing its doors at the end of the 2021 school year, the sisters, lay teachers, and staff set the bar high in academics, faith formation, and helping to guide young people to be stewards of their faith in the world.
OLV has touched many people. Academics has been at the end of this Hemp Hill Street for, you know, a number of years, and I'm going to be sad. My car's not going to know which way to go. After 28 years of bringing myself and my children. So it's been a pleasure and a privilege to know these ladies and to work with them all these years.
The Catholic community of Fort Worth is forever grateful to the dedication of the sisters in their ministry of Catholic education. Throughout the history of OLV Catholic School, these faith-filled educators and principals guided faculty and staff toward doing a little good.
This is the legacy, and this is the history right now, that we're kind of closing the chapter, but we know that it's going to open up another chapter. And there's one thread that is very, very profound, or obvious, which is a thread of joy. There's just such joy in their stories, in their reliving those experiences, and in being able to share those experiences with the same joy, love, and hope. There's always that hope of this could continue. You know, this will continue, actually. In the stories, in the legacy, and in the lives, in the now, in whatever God is presenting today.